In today's After Effects tutorial, I'll show you 5 quick and easy text animations in just a few minutes, so buckle up. Hey, my name is Manuel, I'm a freelance motion designer. Download the project file for free, the link is in the description below. No more time to lose, let's get going. We start with the very basic typewriter. Here's our text layer, which we open and add an animator for the opacity. Set the opacity in the animator to 0. Add a keyframe for start at the beginning and after 1 second and 10 frames, which we set to 100. To smooth the ending a little, we add Easy Ease in through the keyframe assistant. The distance here determines the speed. The smaller the distance, the faster the writing. That's basically it. Easy, right? Let's get to an animation you see a lot in movie trailers. The classic scale. Which means, of course, we animate the scale of the text. Let's set keyframes for the scale at 0, 10 frames and 2 seconds. Then scale the beginning. Little hint, the anchor point should be centered in the middle here. Now, let's scale the beginning way up to 500%. We leave the second one at 100. Then change the third keyframe to 75%. The text flies in from behind the camera, slows down and then disappears or fades out. That's why we set keyframes for the opacity at 2 seconds and 1 second and 10 frames. The last one we set to 0. Awesome, let's turn that principle around, shall we? And let the text fly towards the camera with a fly-through tracking animation. Tracking means we animate the space between the letters and not the size of the text. So we open the text layer and add an animator for tracking. Set a keyframe at the beginning for the tracking amount and leave it at 0. After 1 second and 10 frames, we set it to 30. Next, we fade it in. Set a keyframe for the opacity at the beginning and after 5 frames and set the first one to 0. See how the space between the letters is growing? Now we add some scaling. Add a keyframe for scale at 1 second and 10 frames later we scale way up by around 3600%. The text disappears and seems to fly directly through the camera. By the way, check that the anchor point is centered in the middle. Now we're all warmed up, let's get to something a bit more advanced. Ready? 2 layers moving in opposite directions. The text moves in from the right. Therefore, we need 2 position keyframes, at the beginning and after 20 frames. Next, we change the X value of the first keyframe to around 945. Then we need to let it fade in. Meaning 2 opacity keyframes, the first one at the beginning, 0%, the second one after 20 frames, 100%. Next, we select all keyframes, open the graph editor, make sure the snap icon is activated, and the edit speed graph is selected. We select the 2 right points and pull them down towards the line and drag the handles far to the left. If you look at the curve here, which shows the amount of speed at a certain time, you can see we start rather slow, then quickly speed up, then slow down again. Meaning the text moves very fast at the beginning, then comes to a smooth stop. Alright. Next, we select the rectangle tool and create a shape behind the text. Something like that. We don't want a stroke around the shape, so we set it to 0. Then we use the anchor point tool, and if you hold Command while dragging the point, it snaps. We want the anchor point to be sitting on the left corner of the shape. We unblock this little constraint proportions chain here because we only need to set the width to 0 and after 20 frames set it back to 100. And with the anchor point at the left corner, the shape automatically expands to the right. And again, we open the graph editor to create that smooth ending. One more thing. We select the text layer and add the set matte effect. and select the shape layer as matte. Choose alpha channel. Now the text is visible on the shape only. Nice, works great for quick and easy lower thirds, for example. Still sticking around? Good for you, cause now it's time for the big reveal. First of all, we open the text property and add an animator for the position. We set the Y position to around 155, making sure the text moves down below its bottom border. Set a keyframe for the start value, and after 1 second we set the value to 100. Then we select the two keyframes and open the graph editor. And create a speed curve that starts smoothly, speeds up, and then slows down again. You already know how to do that. Now we add a shape that covers the text. The bottom line should be just below the type. Then we select the text layer and add the set matte effect once again, and choose the shape layer as alpha matte. The shape needs to be invisible. There you go. The type gets revealed as it moves into the shape. Finally, we add a line on the bottom border of the shape by using the pen tool. Add a stroke. Done. Was that easy for you guys? Which one is your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you next time, guys. Bye!